The polarity of EMF induced is such that it tends to produce a current which opposes the change in the magnetic flux that produced it. It is the statement of Lenz's law. Here you can see a diagram is taken. North pole is close to this side coil. If this magnet moves towards this coil, then it will oppose, doesn't allow the north pole to come. So how it can oppose? Means this front of this north pole, north polarity will induce. So the direction of EMF here, you can see it is anti-clockwise direction. We will take several examples, several ways that you can see in the diagram. In the short, we can say the statement of Lenz's law as the direction of the induced EMF or induced current is such that it opposes the change that is producing it. How an induced current can be produced? In Faraday's experiment, we have seen due to relative motion. So here, first I have taken the coil is at rest and magnet is in motion. See, the north pole is coming and it is the top view we are considering. So the coil will not allow to come the north pole towards itself. So it will induce in itself a north polarity. North polarity it will induce. So in this coil, the direction of current is along this. Here, we have taken coil at rest. See here, once again, in this diagram. Later on. Again here, the north pole is approaching. So in this coil, north polarity will induce. Here, south pole is approaching, so it will induce a south polarity in itself. Now, what's your query? Say that one. You know, here, magnetic field coming this one, if it is far away, let it be here a bar magnet, then automatically due to this, there's a field one. Magnetic field one, if a coil is here, let it be. How many field line passing through this coil? Only one. If the same coil comes here, now how many field line passing through this one? Three. So B is changing. So flux is changing. Whenever flux, it is moving. So more and more field lines will come. Now second, coil is in motion and magnet is at rest. See, here in the rest, the coil is moving towards the north pole. So what happens? It may now more and more field lines enters into it. So it will oppose. How it can oppose? Here the north pole of the magnet. So it will induce here a north polarity in itself. Now just see here. It is the north pole and the coil is moving along this side, far away. It was in this figure, it is coming towards north pole. And here, it is going away from the north pole. So if going away from the north pole, towards which polarity coming closer? It is the south polarity. Means it is going away from the north pole, so it will not allow inertia, it will not allow. How it doesn't allow the coil to move? It will induce south polarity, so there will be attraction. So what we can summarize? If a coil is coming close to a pole, repulsion will be. So for the repulsion, alike polarity. If anyone, either coil or magnet, moving away, then the attraction doesn't allow to go away. And for attraction, opposite polarity. And the third is, both coil and magnet are in motion. Though you can design several situations by its own. Here, see, in this one, it is moving with V1. The magnet is moving with V2, both in the same direction. But here, myself considering, V1 is greater than V2. So what happens? It will come more close. Relative velocity, we find out, it will be V1 minus V2 in this direction. So what is ultimately? It is coming close to the north pole. So north polarity, here it is. If V1 is less than V2, then the north pole, obviously the relative velocity will be V2 minus V1. Means V1 we are giving rest and this coil is moving. Magnet is moving. Since north pole is moving away from this one, south polarity, you may say that this south pole is also moving. But this is the closer one. So its impact we have to consider which pole is closer. Now if both are moving in opposite direction, V1 along, coil is moving along right, magnet is moving left, then what happens here? See, it will come whatever the velocity greater or less, means this coil or the magnet, both the north pole approaching this one more closer, doesn't allow, so here the north polarity. Again, if these two are going in opposite direction, means north pole going away, so here the south polarity. So it is a simple way to find out if due to a magnet. Now can we say Lenz's law violates the conservation of energy, that here energy is, current is produced free of cost? No. See here, according to Lenz's law, the induced EMF opposes the change that produced it. It is this opposition against which we perform mechanical work. Either we are moving magnet or coil or both, we are doing some mechanical work. So that mechanical work is compensated as electrical energy and appears in the coil in as electric energy. Thus we can say Lenz's law doesn't violate the law of conservation. If these two are rest, then no question of the induced EMF. Here see, a magnet here, now a circuit. How we can find the direction of current in a circuit? Every year, see, this Lenz's law, since 2010 to 2019, 10 years, and in these 10 years, 8 times, question from Lenz's law. See here, this phase, north pole is coming. So here, it will induce north polarity. So in the north polarity, we take one tips, what will be the direction of current along this? So here. It is this much about the length.